Second talk will be about risk assessment in genetic counseling. Now, it's very much clear to all of you, as a genetic counselor, you need to be aware of how to assess, calculate, predict the risk assessment in every family you approach or they approach you for counseling. I know it's very hard to implement or use different known formulas for calculating risk assessment, but you need to know the basics. You need to know the preliminary facts about how to present to the family or to the consultant who approached you on the risk assessment on basic simple things, okay? Most of the disorders, we know that Mendelian disorders, recessive or autosomal, we can predict easily. But what we are talking about, how you can predict risk assessment just from genetic pedigree, and how you can predict risk assessment based on a lab report. Okay, a lab report done on affected individual that is related to the one who approached you, the consultant who was seeking counseling, and how you can talk to them or talk to her or to him about possible or percentages that his son or his daughter might have the disease or might be a carrier, right? Okay, now what is a genetic risk? It is an essential component of genetic counseling and testing, very much obvious. Now this would be the first question. What is the possibility or percentage that my son or my daughter will have the disease? What is the percentage or possibility that I am a carrier of such disorder in my family? Okay? What is the recurrence risk of if I am having already a baby affected? This is very essential part or essential query in every counseling session. Now, genetic risk refers to the probability of carrying a specific disease-associated mutation or of being affected with a specific genetic disorder. That's a simple definition. Okay? A simple definition of a genetic risk is the probability of me carrying a specific mutation or the probability that I'm transmitting this mutation to my generation, okay? It should be assessed as accurately as possible for family decision making. Now, Manal, I remember she called me or she sent me some reports about HPLC of a couple. And that couple, one of them actually wasn't clear, okay, particularly A2. So they approach her for a decision of marriage or not, to go on with the marriage or not. Very sensitive question. And if you are faced with such conditions, you should not say you can go on with marriage or you cannot go on with marriage. Never say that. What you need to do is give all possibilities if you have a very confirmed diagnosis, a very confirmed report, okay? Very clear report. Give possibilities, probabilities, and don't ever answer to the question that saying, shall we go for marriage or not? Because that would be like a summary, you know, they want you like a final statement of yours. Now we know, no matter what we do, no matter what we investigate, no matter what we apply from all technologies in genetic sequencing, you know, we just talk about next generation sequencing, there is still a small, tiny percentage that we might be wrong. Okay? Always remember that. Always said, theoretically, when you reply to them, calculation basis, what we know in literature, what was presented in the whole world literature, you may have so and so, or you may have, but never say definite. The word definite is not in medicine, okay? So I was waiting for Manal to send me the HPLC report in order to tell her this statement, but now I found a chance to tell you all about it, okay? Shall we go for marriage? I cannot say that. So shall we go, not go? No, I cannot say that. What I can say that 25% you'll have this, 50% you'll have this, 25, 75, and so on. That's what you need to tell them, okay? It usually requires careful consideration and takes into account the following: the diagnosis, as we said, and the mode of inheritance, okay? The analysis of family pedigree, and I'm sure you all do that. The result of the test that can include linkage study. Yani all laboratory tests we just talked about. Laboratory genetic approach, we just talked about linkage study, okay? Linkage, what the word means linkage? A phenotype linked to the site in chromosome. A disease, a gene. Where is it in the chromosome? Linking. We use that, there are certain methods to be used for such a process. What makes it difficult to predict an exact risk assessment figure or exact recurrence risk, certain very much well-known factors. Number one called variable expression. Variable expression, I have Ahmed and Salim, both of them having the mutation. Say Marfan syndrome, dominant disorder, right? But Ahmed is having cardiac, having lens dislocation, having other features. While Salim doesn't have that, have some of the features. They both have the mutation, but the expression of the gene here is more than the expression of in here, okay? So this is really a dilemma, but it's known that variable expression, especially with dominant disorder, is there. So variable expression is a contributing factor that will really affect giving a definite answer of risk assessment and recurrent risk, tamam? Incomplete penetrance. Some dominant disorders are definitely coming either from the mother or the father, okay? But they are free from any phenotype. How can you can say dominant? And my son is having the dominant disease and I'm having nothing, neither me nor his mother, okay? So because the mutation showed incomplete penetrance. Now, incomplete penetrance, a very famous example of incomplete penetrance. Breast cancer, excellent, BRCA1 mutation. You may have mutation, but the penetrance of that is not there. And an example of complete penetrance, 100% is no, neurofibromatosis. Neurofibromatosis has 100% penetrance. Remember these examples, huh? Yeah, but it can be incomplete. You may have the mutation, but the symptoms are delayed. Okay, lakin complete penetrance, gene mutation, phenotype is there, definitely. Complete penetrance, okay? And sometimes we say this disease is 85% of penetrance. It means 85% of those who is having the mutation will have the symptoms, right? While 15 of those who is having the mutation will not have the symptoms. This is how we read penetrance, لما تجينا statement. That this disease has 95% penetrance. So 95% of those who's having the mutation will have the symptoms, while 5% of those who have mutation will not have the symptoms. Tamam? When we say a test can detect those with a mutation by 90%. A test, any test, has 90%, you remember, specificity, sensitivity, okay? So 90% of the disease will detect those with the disease. So among the 100 having the disease, only 90 detected by this test. Like in the other 10 who are having the mutation were not detected. Clear? Okay. Gonadal mosaicism. Gonadal, يعني either germs, sperms, or eggs. صح؟ Okay. Now gonadal mosaicism happening during what? يعني creation of the fetus. During that percentage of those will have the mutation and percentage will not have the mutation. Okay? That's why this can explain the incomplete penetrance of dominant disorder. The baby is having the symptoms, another reason يعني. While his parents are not. If the mutation occurs at early stages of gonadal production, okay, then we'll have a complete penetrance and this will be transmitted to his offspring. If it happens at the later stages, less penetrance and it will have less possibility of inheriting to his next generation. Genomic imprinting. Can somebody tell me what's genomic imprinting? No, it's not like this. This is not the answer, Moses.
Example.
What is, you start with example?
No.
Genomic imprinting is a sort of what we call it comes under something called epigenetics. Yeah, epigenetics, modification of DNA sequence to form a mutation or abnormality without changing the DNA sequence itself. بمعنى, Some diseases, sorry, some genes, we know that alleles from the father one, from the mother one, صح? At every site. They're supposed to work together. Like in some areas, in some chromosomes, or some phenotypes, or some proteins, only that allele which comes from the father should work. And the mother doesn't, it's not important. And in some other issues also, the allele which comes from the mother should work, should give the job. And usually two alleles work. We do have two alleles for every protein, right? Okay, one is coming from the father, one is coming from the mother, right? So in certain disorders, only the allele which comes from the father should work. And in some, only the allele which comes from the mother should work, right? Now, in case the allele from the father was deleted, however, the mother allele is there, but that particular syndrome or that particular phenotype needs the father allele, which is not there. An example is Prader-Willi syndrome. And if deletion comes from taking the mother allele, while the job has to be performed or the protein has to be produced by the mother allele, the father allele is there, but it's not important in the function. Maternal deletion. Example, Angelman syndrome. Okay? So genomic imprinting, it reflects it's important in identifying the source or the function of the gene depends on the parental origin. Function of the gene depends which parental of origin that gene come from. Right?
What's the relation between imprinting genome and uniparental disomy?
Ah, that's another, no, that's a different, another phenomena. Uniparental disomy, it means that the two alleles are coming from one parent. A. Okay, but this one, يعني in certain, especially chromosome. Okay, certain chromosome, which number? Which chromosome that has Prader-Willi Angelman area? That 15. Okay, remember that. Okay, so we know the contributing factor, variable expression, incomplete penetrance, gonadal mosaicism, and imprinting. Are we doing well? Excellent. Probability, احتماليات. Defined as the proportion of times it occurs in a large series of events. Definition of probability. Okay? Definition is that the proportion or nisbet that this might happen in certain, among certain events. Certain events, certain number might appear among certain events. Okay? Conventionally, probability is indicated as a proportion of 1. يعني from 0 إلى 1. دائما الاحتماليات from 0 to 1. Okay, either one total probability, it's there. Zero, nil, nothing, and in between. Are you okay? Okay, a probability of zero infers that the outcome will never be observed, definitely. One indicates that it will always be observed. صح? Range, what, zero to one. So, احتمال one means what? Definitely is there. احتمال zero, definitely it's not there. So probability of 0.25 indicates that, as an example, an average of particular outcome will be observed 1 in 4, or 25%. Okay? 0.25, هي نفسها 25%. هي نفسها 1 in 4. So when you ask about recessive disorders, what's the probability I might have an infected disease? 0.25, or 25%. تمام؟ It's good if you use this number. يعني لما تتكلموا كل الناس تقول 25% لا أنت تقول 0.25 وكل الناس ما تستخدم كلمة probability فلما تقول probability 0.25 بتخليهم يلفوا يدوروا where this come from okay then he will realize or she will realize that you really know the content you really know the knowledge okay the probability that the outcome will not occur is 0.75 which can also be expressed as a 3 chances out of 4. لاحظوا 1 in 4 25 3 in 4 75 يعني الفيجر هذه مع البروبابيلتي تكون كذي شكلها. Are you okay? Okay. Now we'll just have a quick look on risk calculation on genetic pedigree. An example of genetic pedigree, see both parents affected, I mean first generation, labeled one, as you can see. You see where, there one? 1. Labeled by degree will make things easy when you read it, okay? So generation 1. So if you talk about the father, how you will say? How you write father? 1. Mother? 1, 2. Okay. His daughter is 2, 2. His another daughter, 2, 4. His son or their son, 2, 3, and so on. Here is unknown whether he's having the disease or not. Here we know that they are clear from phenotype. If dominant, they don't have the problem. If recessive, they may be carrier, but they are clear from the phenotype. This symbol means that unknown. Yani, when you see a degree, and asking you what could be, or what could be is this yani fetus a carrier or affected or not? Yani, it will appear like this. Okay. طيب. As you said, the first one without any color, normal, affected will be dark. You know about this, of course, right? Mm-hmm. You know about the female and the male, an individual of unknown phenotype or unknown sex. Broadband will have this star. Yeah, but sometimes they use an arrow. Broadband is what? When we talk about genetic degree, when I say broadband, broadband, what does it mean? Proband is what?
The client who came.
أيوة صح. أيوة أبغى حد يشارك نبغى إجابات. Proband is the first case approached or diagnosed or discovered. After which we made family pedigree. Okay. طيب طبعا مثل إحنا تكلمنا عن هذا اسم الترقيم. Okay. 3-1 like that. Right. And the male will female وكذا generation 1, generation 2, 3, 4 and so on. A proband that individual whose genetic condition is being acquired about is identified either this أو حتى نجم أو حتى شو اسمه arrow. Okay, طبعا تعرفوا شو اسمه you know about the genetic arrows, consanguinity arrows, okay, the outcome of marriage arrow and so on. You all know that. طبعا Bayesian analysis named after the scientist Thomas Bayes. This was published in an article called The Doctrine of Chances. يعني or labeled, it was labeled like that يعني أو المسؤول أو المعرفة اللي يعرف الاحتمالات in 1763. Okay. And he's basically an English philosopher. In his later years he took a deep interest in حساب الاحتماليات probabilities and he suggested a formula how to consider probability, and I'm going to tell you and try to make it very much simple how to use Bayesian formula or table in calculation. تمام؟ Right, هو he used to calculate the probabilities in a wide variety of circumstances, okay, in all aspects, with pedigree, with diagnosis, with history, in all aspects there is a way to calculate using Bayesian. Okay, هذا اللي ميزها. In all circumstances. Used to calculate genetic risk in complex pedigrees and probability of having or lacking the disease. It also provides a valuable method for determining the overall probability of any event or any outcome. It considered all the initial possibilities. Okay. يعني we have different hypotheses I'm going to talk about. We usually have usually two hypotheses, but sometimes you may have three hypotheses. Okay. Hypothesis يعني نظرية فكرة. Okay. It combines the probability that an event will occur with probability that it will not occur with the probability. يعني if we think hypothesis that a carrier is there or she or he is a carrier, the other hypothesis is what? He or not a carrier. صح? Now if he is a carrier, what will be the probability? And if he is not a carrier, what will be the probability? لاحظ يعني something conditional. يعني depends on the previous assumptions. Okay? طيب البايسيان analysis table it looks like this, right? Let me draw it for you here better. So we have Thank you. right? Okay. So the hypothesis, our hypothesis here, and usually, as I said earlier, there could be maybe three hypotheses, but we do have two, يعني known hypotheses, either a carrier or not carrier. Okay. Right. Okay. The first one to calculate is prior or first or primary prior probability. Carrier or not carrier. Okay. Then based on that conditional probability. Right. Okay. Then something called joint probability. Okay. Joint probability. Then after all that, after prior and conditional based on prior and then joining them, what could be the final? Because my question is always, what is the carrier risk of this individual? That question will only answer it after going through all this. And we call it after probability or posterior probability. Are we clear? طيب, ناخذ example. Let me go first, quick definitions, as I said. Prior or anterior, the first one, right? Is the initial probability of each event. And it is known as its prior probability and is based on the ancestral or anterior information. And we know that a person might be a carrier or not a carrier, okay? So we know that. The conditional, the observation that modify these prior probabilities. And if he's a carrier, then conditional probability will be like this. If he is not a carrier, then conditional probability will be like this. Okay? So probabilities allow conditional probabilities to be determined. Conditional. يعتمد على. مرتبط ب. Okay? Conditional. The posterior, as I said, the final, the question, the answer of your question. I'm going to give you a few examples so you will be able to know that, inshallah. The final probability for each event is known as posterior or relative probability and is obtained by dividing the joint probability over the event by the sum of all joint probabilities. Okay? Right? Are we okay?
Yes.
Basic calculation. Your calculator is gahzat? Ready? Okay, and as I said, joint or resulting probability of each event, the outcome and its joint probability. طيب. Before we go, I just would like you to understand which we use also in Bayesian formula, the whole addition or multiplication. The addition, that probability that the baby will be either a boy or a girl, usually one. في شيء آخر غير boy and girl؟ ماشي. صح؟ Yeah. Boy or girl. صح؟ طيب احتمال أن يكون boy واحتمال أن يكون girl. Okay, المجموع إيش؟ One. Right? So multiplication, as an example, if the mother is found on ultrasound to be carrying twins who are not identical, then the probability that both the first and the second twin will be boys equal to half, pardon, half, or half. لكن because they are twin, we do multiplication. لكن above, they are not twins, single baby. So we add. يعني عندي event in one baby وعندي event in two ف one baby half half ف adding one لكن twin قد يكون two of them girls two of them boys one of them girl one of them هكذا لذلك نرجع للmultiplication تكرار right okay ناخذ example ناخذ example على how to calculate Bayesian formula right I want some of you to read Sumaya, read.
Consultant.
Female. What is consultant? Who is consultant? I'm asking Sumaya.
Who came?
Who came? Very good. Carry on. Come on.
Female has two brothers with
Kennedy disease.
Kennedy disease.
Kennedy disease. اسمه Kennedy disease. وهو عبارة عن X-linked spinal and bulbar muscular atrophy. إذن عندي X-linked disorder. Right? وهذه الفيميل has two brothers with Kennedy disease, right? مثل ما هو واضح هني شنو؟ This is what we are talking about. بدقري نستخدمها واضح. فهو X-linked بالتالي X-linked means what? X-linked means what? يعني this is a male and this is a female, صح؟ So X-linked means that if the male is having it, then he's having the disease, صح؟ And the mother should be, our recessive I'm talking about. Mother should be always a carrier. Right, okay. Right. So we are talking about this lady, and the question is, what is her carrier risk? We have only pedigree. We don't have results. We have only pedigree. Pedigree said that her mother is what?
Carrier.
Definitely, she is a carrier. Otherwise, you know, this, where they get their X from?
Mother.
Father? Why? Because the father is giving them Y. صح؟ Will not give X. فبالتالي he got even mother is carrier. So we are talking about this lady having X-linked recessive. What is her carrier risk? Okay. Again, the pedigree just for. As I said, we have two hypotheses. Carrier or non-carrier. Right. Now, if we say that she's a carrier, what is the probability that she's a carrier? Half, 50. Very good. That's a different thinking. So she's a carrier is half. Non-carrier? No three quarters? Half. Okay? Okay, now as I said here, she is having three unaffected male sons. Okay, so three unaffected male sons, she is a carrier. No, we assume that she is a carrier. Fairest assumption. She is a carrier, صح? And the three unaffected sons. So conditional probability is half. Times half, times half. Now we think that she's a carrier. We are thinking that she's a carrier. We know that she's having three unaffected sons. And then conditional probability is every son is getting the normal X from the mother. Mother is having what? For every chance, because we have three normal. لأن لو abnormal will X linked معناته they will appear like this. But they definitely have the normal X. بالتالي she is giving her sons the first half. Okay? Right. This will be 1 over 8. Now, if she is not a carrier. She is not a carrier. So her sons will be clear. So if she's not a carrier, she will never give any abnormal thing. صح؟ بالتالي what is the conditional probability? One. She's not a carrier. With three normal sons. It's okay. واضح؟ طيب. Now joint. أنا عندي 1/8. وعندي هنا شنو؟ Half. So still in a carrier. So joint means half. Joint. No, not plus. Multiply. Okay. Joint. This one. This one. Joint. This one. This one. So half times. And here. Fozia. By one. كم result هنا? 1 over 16 هنا تمام اوكي now I have here one joint 1 over 16 and here half now to this is my answer to the question what is her carrier risk اللي هو ال posterior probability ال final probability okay what we do actually if we think still a carrier then 1 over 16 على او divided by sum total okay يعني البوستيريال فاينل انسر مالي يكون الجوينت بروبابيلتي مالها وهي كارير ديفايدد اوفر ذا سم اوف اول جوينت بروبابيلتي اللي هو 116 زائد 102 صح على اند هير سميه if she is not a career
1/2
divided
1/16
the sum of 1/16 plus 1 نشوف الانسرز اوكي رايت سو ذا probability if she is a career will be sorry the probability if she is a career will be 1/9 اوكي okay. طبعا definitely if she is يعني هو احنا نتكلم عن مجموع البروبابيلتيز كم دائما مجموع البروبابيلتيز 1 فاذا بروبابيلتي شي از كارير از 1/9 بدون ما احسب بروبابيلتيز اوف شي از نوت ا كارير ويل بي كم 8/9 صح عشان المجموع يكون ايش ار وي دوينج جود ولا لا اعيد اوكي بريور طبعا في اكزامبل ثاني براوي انه طريقه اخرى بريور يعني عندي مدر ما اعرف ابى احسب الهايبوثيسز مالتي عندي تو هايبوثيسز ايذر شيز ا كارير اور شيز نوت ا كارير اف شيز ا كارير هذا ماي بريور كم النسبه كارير هاف صح هاف في حل اخر يا كارير نوت كارير ما في حل اخر اذا هاف بيكوز بروبابيلتي فروم 0 تو 1 دائما النظريه الرياضيه الاحتمالات from 0 to 1 طيب if she is a career خلينا هني the conditional probability ارجع اشوف الشارت عندي يعني هي career وعندها 3 normal male sons او عفوا 3 normal sons صح فاذا كانت career وعندها 3 sons معناته كل مره كان يظهر ايش تعطي نورمال اكس يعني هي كارير ما اعطت الاب نورمال اكس يعني مثلا لو عندي واحد اني افكتد سن بيكون الوضع مختلف لكن 3 نورمال سنز فهي كل مره تعطي نورمال اكس وبالتالي الكارير مو شو معنى كارير يحمل شيء عشان ايش يوصله يحمل شيء عشان ايش يوصله ولا لا فكل مره بما انها افترض انها كارير تعطي نورمال فبالتالي كل حسابات النورمال هاف ثم هاف ثم هاف فكل ولاداتها عباره عن 1/8 هذا المذر يعني 3 كيدز اذا كنت كارير وعندك 3 سنز معناته الكارير كابابيلتي مالتك او الكونديشنال بروبابيلتي مالتك 1/8 عندك 4 سنز 1/2/2/2 2 تايمز 2 ايوه 1/16 طيب if she is a, if she is not a career خلاص هنتكلم عن اكسلنت كدرز she is not a career definitely she will give normal sons وبالتالي احتماليات انه career 1 الجوينت joining prior على conditional my hypothesis before I start مع ناتج الهايبوثيسز في حالة good condition اللي هو either career ولا either not career فالجوينت في حالة الكارير هو هاف مثل ما افترضتني تايمز الاوتكم اللي هني فطلع معي كم 1/16 هنا برضو جوينينج ذس 1 ملتبلاي باي ذات 1 يطلع معي هاف طيب الحين انا عندي الجوينت بروبابيلتيز جمعتهم جوينت جوينينج بروبابيلتي فبغيت احسب الكارير ريسك مالها لما هي كارير ريسك اوكي مالها يعني بالادر بي بس لما هي كارير فعندي الجوينت بروبابيلتي مالها اللي خاص فيها وهي كارير اقسمه على مجموع الجوينت بروبابيلتي يعني نسبه عادي طريقه حساب النسبه طريقه يعني مثلا عندي 100 نفر خمسه منهم عندهم ايش ورقه حمراء 95 عندهم ورقه خضراء كم احتماليه اصحاب الورقه الحمراء 5 على 100 مش 5 على 5 5 على 100 صح فهم هي التوتال طبعا في النهايه ينجمع نفس الطريقه فيكون هذا الجوينت بروبابيلتي مالها هي على مجموع الاثنين، جمعت هذا مع هذا اللي هي جوينت بروبابيلتي مال الاحتمالات كلها، وطلعت منها البروبابيلتي مالها لما كارير، طبقت نفس النظريه لما هي نوت كارير. واضح؟ اذا اللي جاب على السؤال هناك ان الكارير ريسك مالها 1 اوفر 9. تمام؟ you can change the figure. مثلا تقولي يعني من كل 9 واحد
مثلا
نرسم 9 ونقول من 9 1. لا ما في داعي ترسمي هي يعني بعد ما تحسبي انت، قولي يعني مثلا لو 9 اولاد واحد منهم بيكون متاثر كارير، اوكي، والبقيه لا.
ما نقدر نحدد
هذه
طبعا.
لا هو احتمال في كل ولاده.
في كل ولاده
بالضبط. طيب نرسم جدول اخر لمساله اخرى. ايش اكتب هنا؟ ايوه وايش اكتب هنا؟ طيب نشوف المثال الثاني مختلف طبعا. بداية كان based on genetic pedigree، الثاني بيكون عن طريق ايش؟ ان عندي ريبورت. بشرى صوت عالي. So we are talking about cystic fibrosis. إيش معلوماتي عن cystic fibrosis؟ يلا كملي بشرى.
The consultant is an affected
European
person and her brother died years early of complication of cystic fibrosis.
طيب. The pedigree, this is the case I'm discussing, the consultant. وعندها brother died. صح؟ طيب كملي.
She underwent carrier test which detected 90% of disease allele in apparent version.
Caucasian. عندي تيست موجود في المختبر where she went. She عندها father and mother carrier، عندها اخو مات، تبغى تعرف her carrier status. هناك ما تعرف شيء. هناك عندها عمها مات، عمها مصاب، her uncle was affected. No result. She didn't go to the lab. وبرضه انا اعطيت احتمالات. This lady went to do the test. Okay, she went to do the test. Right? هذا التيست ايش ميزته؟ فوزية صح صحي معي شوي قري. She underwent
carrier testing which detected 90% of disease allele.
European Caucasian. So this test is detecting 90% with the disease. What does it mean?
10% don't have the disease.
No, they do have, but they are not detected. يعني التست هذا عندي السبيسيفيتي مالته. So he can identify the mutation in 90% of those who are having the disease. Test يعني هي يعني هذا الكابيلتي مال الابيلتي مال التست. It's only test. So only can detect 90%. وبالتالي 10% مع ان عندهم ديزيز التست كانت ديتكت. واضح الصوره؟ اوكي. So it can detect 9 over 10 with ايش؟ With positive صح؟ And it cannot detect 1 over 10 with positive also. Are we clear؟ طيب. She tests negative for all 25 mutations. شو معنات الاخر جمله سمية؟ she underwent the test. هذا التست يبحث عن 25 mutation that cause cystic fibrosis. So what was her result? وهي ما عندها clinical symptoms. هي تبحث عن career status لان recessive disorder. فلما راحت هذا التست بين انها نيجاتيف، انها ما عندها مشكله. كلير؟ صح؟ طيب. هذه البيدجري وهذه ايش؟ الهايبوثيسيس. طيب. Now we are talking about recessive disorder with testing. واحنا وينو ذكروا البونيت سكوير؟ ذكروا البونيت سكوير؟ ذكروا كارير؟ كارير هذه الاحتمالات المتوقعة. اوكي؟ طيب ناو نعبي الجدول. We have a prior conditional joint posterior. طيب we say that prior she is either a carrier or not a carrier. Now from recessive disorder we know that definitely she have no, has no symptoms. Okay, now if she what is the probability that she might be a carrier? No, not 50. Are they normal? Looking normal. Looking normal. Two are carriers. صح؟ One with هذا يعني برع. إذا بقى معايا three. She looks like this. صح ولا لا؟ She looks like this. صح ولا لا؟ She looks like this. But definitely she doesn't look like this. ليش؟ بالضبط. Because this one is having the disease. يعني recurrent chest infection صح ولا لا؟ She is not. فاحتماليه انها كارير از
3 اوت 4
اكسلنت برافو سميه 2 اوت اوف 3 2 اوت اوف 3 لان شي كان نوت بي ذس وان ات اول دونت وري ايم نوت غانا كومبليكيت ذا كيس ان يور اكزام بس ذس فور يو تو نو اوكي سو 2 اوفر سو نون كارير از أميرة no not one 2 over 3 career 1 over 3 okay are we okay
yes.
I see we're not laughing طيب الحين نيجي على الكونديشنال اوكي هي عندها طبعا the unknown unknown okay we don't know the sex of this baby we don't know the mutation status of this baby right now the conditional that if she's a carrier okay which one
because she has one child
yeah but we don't know we don't know about this child we don't know about him we don't know now we know we have apart from the degree we have something else no. we have in this case
90%
a test okay a test قال انها نيجاتيف a test قال ايش what I know about this test ان 10% من اللي عندهم career status بيطلعوا برضه نيجاتيف مش كده okay so 1 over 10 كونديشنال هذا لان ما اعرف قد تكون هي يعني قد تكون هي كارير ستاتس لان عندي مشكله في التست اللي هي سوته ان 10% بيكونوا ايش؟ يعني الريبورت جاني انها نيجاتيف هي انا عندي ابحث عن احتماليه انها كارير ستاتس الريبورت جاني نيجاتيف بس قد تكون هي ايش؟ من 10% يعني 10% of them عندهم ديزيز but the test didn't detect them so How to calculate conditional?
1 by 10
multiplied by? No? Every
2.3
equal to? Equal to? 2 over? Okay. 15 صح؟ I'm not career. No, no, no. Conditional. Conditional. She's not a career. One. By the way, I'm studying this with you also. يعني I didn't know this much before, but I'm studying it with you. Okay? So I made you some mistakes, so we'll discuss it among you. فاهم؟ واضح؟ طيب. Okay, the joint probability is the same way we use there. Is it true? And this is 1 times. We did the same here? Right. Yes, same. Okay. Right. Let us see it here better because I think I'm lost somewhere here. Right, okay. No multiply, sorry. I should not multiply this. Multiplication only in joint. Okay, because I have a test. No, we have a test. Because we have a test, we don't have a degree. Okay. Direct test, 1 over 10. So 1 over 15, we got it here, should be here, right? And 1 over 3, we should be here. Here 1 times 1, 1 and 3. Okay? Right. So as you can see there, after we identify the joint probability based on the test, which will detect only the, which will have negative result for, sorry, positive, which will not detect those with the disease from the test, 1 over 10, and always the remaining is 1. So joint probability, as I said, 1 over 10 times 2 over 3, which is 1 over 15, and this is 1 times 1 over 3, as we said here, which is 1 over 3. Now, how to calculate posterior? Sumaya, wait, Sumaya. We have the figures here. 1 over 15. Posterior probability, posterior probability is the final, the probability. Remember, 5 with red flags, 95 with green flags. So probability of those with red flags is 5 over 100, صح? So probability is 1 over 15 over?
1 over 15 uh-huh. Plus 1 divided by 3.
1 over 3, okay? طيب, for this here, Amira. Look here, Amira. 1 over 3, صح? 1 over 3. مش multiply. Divided on. مجموع ال.
Plus 1
over 3. Okay, 1 over 6, صح? وبالتالي. So what's the posterior probability of non-carrier? Y5 plus over 6. The posterior probability of a carrier is 1 over 6. So, the non-carrier? 1. Bravo, Ali. 5 over 6. Clear? Aid? Aid. Okay. طيب. We have a pedigree and we have test result. Pedigree said that it is recessive. Pedigree said what? Recessive. So it means that either you have it or not have it or a carrier. ثلاثة صح؟ طيب. عندي test said that they can detect 90%. يعني 10% having the disease, this test will not detect them. Okay? There I have a pedigree only, no test result. So this test result is the condition. That I'm using, condition, الشرط, المقياس, الميزان. هناك كان الكونديشن مالي بديجري. Here, condition مالي a test. فالتست is saying that 1 over 10, okay, or 10 over 100, which is 1 over 10, okay, will always shows, will not be detected. Now, since I'm talking about recessive disorder, the possibility that an individual with no symptoms be a carrier is 2 over 3, not 2 over 4. And a possibility is not a carrier, 1 over 3, صح? Okay. So, 2 over 3 and 1 over 3. بسيطة, صح? Hypothesis, carrier, not carrier. The condition هنا يقول لي إن 10% she might be, and I'm talking about she's a carrier. She's a carrier. وشي done the test. والتست قال negative, ما عندها شيء. She might be from the 10%. فالكونديشن 1 over 10. كلير؟ وطبعا هنا دائما يكون في شيء از نوت كارير ومن ال 90% فتقريبا 1. اوكي؟ الجوينت يجمع هذول او ملتبلاي هذول الثنتين. يعني المهمة الرئيسية المين ميشن از تو فيل ذيس سبيسز. البقية عبارة عن رياضيات بحتة. اوكي؟ فالجوينت ملتبلاي ذيس باي ذيس ملتبلاي ذيس باي ذيس. طيب الجوينت بروبابيلتي مال كارير هو الجوينت مال كارير على السم اوف اول جوينت. الجوينت بروبابيلتي اوف نون كارير هو الجوينت بروبابيلتي اوف نون كارير على مجموع الجوينت بروبابيلتيز. النسب العاديه، النسب العاديه. اوكي، مثل ما قلت يعني ريد فلاج وجرين فلاج ويلو فلاج، كيف تحسبها؟ نمبر اوف يلو فلاج على توتال نمبر. هنا النمبر اوف جوينت بروبابيلتي اوف ا كارير على توتال جوينت بروبابيلتيز. اوكي، طيب ناخذ كويك اكزامبلز اوف جينيتك بيديجريز. اوكي، ريد كونسنتريت اند ام جوين ديفايد ذا كويشنز تو ايفريبادي. اوكي، ناو اكزامبل 1، يو سي ذيس بيديجري منال، صح صحيح معي. The question is, read it.
In the degree which the following female females is less likely to be heterozygous, heterozygous for the rare X-linked recessive gene 3-1-3-3-3-5.
Okay, منال. The conditions اللي معاي شنو هي؟
X-linked
recessive. أول شيء X-linked. إيش؟
recessive.
Recessive. Right? Okay, then the question is, which of the following females is least likely to be طبيعي heterozygous. We are talking about X-linked recessive. الفيميل تكون عادة ايش؟ كارير. كارير يعني ايش؟ homozygous؟ heterozygous، صح؟ Okay. Is least likely to be heterozygous for the rare X-linked gene, you know, the disease اللي هني. Now I have one female. هو حدد لي صح؟ Generation 3-1, Generation 3-3, Generation 3-5. Three females. Which one of them is least likely to be a carrier? How many? Okay, go to Generation 1. Go to generation 1, صح؟ Who is affected? طبيعي، we are talking about X linked ايش؟ Recessive. فالفاذر عنده 1X. Right. Now we have the father and mother, they got generation 2. But my concern is generation 3, صح؟ So how can I use generation 2 to detect which one will be least likely to have? Okay.
Which is
okay.
So that 3 will be not a carrier.
Which 3?
2-3.
2-3? Yeah, definitely, because he's getting only Y from the father.
Yes.
And the affected member is the father now.
So okay. His daughter is to me less.
But what this has to do with the father? What 2-1 has to do with the father? Look clearly to the degree. Concentrate. This man has nothing to do with the father and mother. صح؟
Yes.
This father, affected father and the normal mother, they got one daughter, one son, one daughter. صح؟ Right. Now, I have a male grandson affected similar like his grandfather.
Yes.
So he got it from?
His
mom. So mother was a carrier. So the mother gave it to? Right. The question is, this female, are all result of this marriage. صح؟ يعني by one another. So which one of them will be أقل least إن يكون عندها career. يعني this is career definitely, صح؟ يعني where he got it from. Okay. So which one of these three will be least career? منال.
ما زلت مصر على 3-3.
But you didn't say 3-3. Did you say 3-3? No. You said no 3-3. You said 3-3? You said what?
3-3.
Is what? Least Trazagas. Explain it to me.
As I said also, yani yeah. 3, her father, 3-3, her father got the Y chromosome only from his father.
Okay.
So, yani not effective. Not carrier, you become.
Okay, so how this?
And his wife has nothing to do with that father.
Right. Right. What about this generation? Why not 3-3, 3-5? So what Manal was saying is absolutely right. We have two daughters of this father. They may carry the X, affect the X. Like in this guy definitely did not carry it. So what's coming from this guy will be least likely to be heterozygous. واضح? Very good. طيب. هذا الجواب. انزين. We have Fawzia. Read it. Okay, so the question is, I have a mother, a patient, sorry, is getting married and comes to you for counseling. She has a brother with X-linked recessive. Okay, her brother is affected with X-linked recessive disease. Now, her mother's father also had the disease. يعني, her grandfather having the disease. صح? So her brother is having the disease and her grandfather having the disease. She would know the probability of her being a carrier of the disease. نفس السؤال اللي we talked about, who is least and who is not least. Okay, she want to know. And if so, she would like to know the probability that she will pass the disease to her children if she's a carrier. طيب. We need to draw a degree for this, no problem. Okay, as I said earlier, her mother was a carrier. صح? صح? ليش؟ لأن her father is بالضبط. She has a 50% a chance of being a carrier depending. ليش؟ لأن her brother is affected and her mother is a carrier. Okay, so بحسابات الـ X-linked العادية. حسابات الـ X-linked العادية. Okay, إن she is 50% a carrier. طبعا depending where she got the chromosome on. إذا جات من father فshe is 50% normal. وإذا جات من mother فshe is 50% carrier. If she is a carrier, she won't like to know her son or she would like to know that she passed this to her children بشكل عام. So if she's a carrier, she will pass the affected X to her sons بنسبة 50%. صح؟ mother تعطي الX لأن sons يأخذوا من الY من الفادر والX من المادر. صح؟ And her daughters will not be affected because her daughters إيش؟ No, will not be affected لأن إحنا نعرف إن بالضبط. برافو. طيب بشرى. We have a pedigree. Okay. Usually لما أتكلم عن inheritance أركز على ال first generation ولا second والthird والfourth. إيش معنى inheritance؟ no. Inheritance معناته أتأكد من طريقة سريان الجين. وبالتالي أنا محتاج إلى generation 2 generation 3. صح؟ Okay. يلا هذا hint. I gave you a hint. So you need to concentrate on generation what? Which generation? How many generations are there?
Three generations.
I'm talking to Bushra. So third generation you will concentrate on, صح? طيب. Third generation في one male affected, مش كذا؟ طيب. البيدجري كلها. البيدجري كلها. إيش نوعية الانهيرتنس؟ بلاش dominant or recessive. إيش نوعيته؟ Sex linked؟ ولا autosomal؟ ليش ما قلتي 6 لينكد؟
Because of the male and female.
Excellent. Bravo, Bushra. Bravo. طيب. Now it's autosomal. Autosomal. Okay. Now we need to know what? We need to know what? The question is pattern of inheritance. We need to know whether it's autosomal hash or and now you answer me. Why you said that?
It's skip one generation to another.
Okay.
And affecting both male and female.
Now this male child is affected, صح? And we know it's not sex linked. So definitely carriers. صحيح؟ بالتالي recessive. Okay بشرى؟ Excellent. Very good بشرى. طيب هذا اللي عم يبين. نوف. Take your time. Take your time. Very good. طيب. سمعتوا عن horizontal inheritance و vertical inheritance. الvertical inheritance عادة يكون ايش عادة؟ dominant. vertical. اما الرساسي بيكون اكثر عن واحد. عشان كذي. So both parents have the trait. Both parents have the trait. Okay. لو كان رساسي. لو كان رساسي. Affected, affected. صح؟ ورساسي. معناته الكل لكن انا عندي patient هنا not having the disease this one not having the disease it means that he is from the 50% okay طيب اميره read the question read the question
what better opportunities does this trait follow
okay first of all tell me sex linked or autosomal sex linked بديجري inheritance ولا autosomal inheritance؟ شل what's the difference between sex linked inheritance and autosomal؟ No, X linked means that mostly males. No, 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 mostly males بيكون. لكن في الautosomal يكون both sexes. حفظناها؟ Okay. طيب هذه شنو؟ Autosomal. طيب المود اوف انهيرتنس ايش تشوفي؟ سوري هيك باعتبار ان all affected all affected طيب There, look at the mother there. Okay? Let us assume that it is dominant. Look at the mother. She gave it to three of her kids, صح? طب look at the mother only affected. Mother only. The father should be a carrier, صح? I will say this is recessive. And you said it is dominant. Do you know that both of us are right? This can be implied on both recessive and dominant. I just told you. يعني see that part where the mother only affected. بالضبط. Okay. And see here down. So this can fit in both. طيب موزة.
Why linked diseases?
No. Read the question. Read the question.
What pattern of inheritance does this trait follow? Just the father is affected and he transmits to only his boy.
To grandsons. These grandsons are a result of marriage of one of his daughters. صح؟ So only one of his daughters married to another man we don't know about. And then she had three affected. Okay. Because mostly males are affected, it's X-linked, children had, but parents do not have, so it is recessive. Right? Okay? طبعا recessive, يعني why mother عندها 2X's, مش كده؟ لكن only 1X يشتغل. يعني الكومبوننت اوف جينز في الاكس اللي عند المذر هي نفس الكومبوننت اوف اكس اللي عند الفادر. المذر عندها اثنين. سو معناته انهم جرعات اكثر من الجين؟ لوجيك صح؟ But only one X work. Why? There is a phenomenon called X inactivation. Okay? في X inactivation phenomena ان يكون only one X شغال. إذا حصل أي مشكلة في الانكتيفيشن هذه ممكن المذر تكون معها سيمتومز وهي كارير اوف ريسيسيف ديسوردر اكس لينكد تمام؟ يعني فيري رير لكنها يعني نحطها في بالنا هاي يسمونها ليون هايبوثيسيس. طيب سمية
what pattern of inheritance does this trait follow?
So we have here a mother. Her son is married to another from another mom with the same syndrome, صح? As you can see, 5 and 6, they have the disease. Right? So if it is recessive, it means what?
All they have.
Small r. There is no other chance, okay? But we have one normal female, صح? طيب. So this is بالضبط. اوكي طيب question اخر هو didn't answer فوزية no great read the question
the what pattern of an inheritance does this trait follow
tricky
why can't
be
so why this guy is not affected? Okay. في الأوتوسومال okay it's good to know that يعني male and female and not only male but when you thought of six linked You should consider the father there. So that's not there. So X-linked is طيب. Now we have an affected individual here, صح? And we have normal phenotype mother. Recessive عادة يكون ايش? Carrier لكن normal phenotype. Okay? تمام? It seems that this guy is having small r, and his wife is having capital R, small r. وبالتالي they got one out of four affected. طيب أميرة
What's the genotype of individual
9? So we have number, the question is about number 9. This female, what, how many generations are here? Three? Point to them, tell me, which one?
We have the first one, two, three.
So 3, 9, he's talking about 3, 9, صح? Yeah. So the question is what's the genotype of individual 3, 9? Genotype. What difference between phenotype and genotype? Features, okay? والجينوتايب الجينيتيك كومبوننت يعني اللي هو affected احنا قلنا بالريسيسيف الجينوتايب ماله ار سمول ار سمول الكارير ار كابيتال ار سمول النورمال ار كابيتال ار كابيتال صح؟ هذا يسمونه ايش؟ جينوتايب. The question is talking about what is the genotype of individual number 9 اللي هو بديجري 3-9. We talked about this example just now. This is what kind of what is the mode of inheritance أول شيء؟ أتسمى إيش؟ فيكسن. هنا small r small r صح؟ وهنا بالضبط ليش؟ لأن عندهم one affected. نشوف الاحتمالات. إذا أنا مرج between small r r capital r small. أنا أبغى أميرة تتكلم بس. أعطيني احتمالات أميرة. R capital, R small. Excellent. R capital, R small. بعدين؟ لا لا. So this will have the disease اللي هو number 10. This will have the disease اللي هو ايش؟ number 10. This can be 9, can be
8.
Okay.
8
oh sorry. Okay. هذا الجواب. Individual 9 is AS او R capital R small. Okay مثل ما قلنا تمام؟ اوكي؟ طيب ناخذ اكزامبل ثاني. The same degree. سمية. اليوم سمية مبدعة اليوم. Very good. كمل.
If individual 5 and 6 had another child, what is the probability of being affected?
Okay. 5 and 6, they have 4. What mode of inheritance is this? Hello. Now these 5 and 6, they have 4. 3 normally, phenotypically normal. 1 affected. صح? Okay. The question is, what is the probability of the of it being affected? احنا عملنا بدقري. عملنا بدقري. هذا R capital R small. أي واحد فيهم 5 ولا 6?
6.
6. R small R small? 5. طيب. What is the probability that they may have affected son? Now, as you can see, this is called what? R capital R small called what? Carrier. Bravo. This one? This one? This one? إذا كم probability? 50%. طيب 50% or half. Thank you. Thank you very much. Well done. Okay, you may you'll have this one in Moza flash. Go today and try to read it, study it. تعودوا نفسكم على البديجري من أول look. Okay, وحسبوا second, third, fourth generation وسووا correlation. هذا rare لكن استخدمي الجينوتايب. If you face such difficulty, عملي جينوتايب dominant و جينوتايب recessive. شوفي which one is fit. Can they both fit? Yes, it can be both. It cannot be dominant, then it is recessive. It cannot be recessive, then it's dominant. يعني this way. Don't worry, both will be right. إذا كانوا possibly both. زين لكن قراءة البيدجري مهمة جدا نعرف الجنريشنز نعرف كيف نعمل الجينوتايبنج على البيدجري نفسها اوكي كيف سسبكت نعرف يعني مثلا المود اوف انهرتنس ما اذا كان فيرتيكال او هوريزونتال اوكي غالبا فيرتيكال دوميننت والهوريزونتال ريسيسيف غالبا
والاكس لينك لازم تكون في فيرست جنريشن وتيجي في
الاكس لينك موستلي بتحصلي فيميلز بات But في another disorder called Y linked disorder يعني هو rare لكنه موجود بس you need to consider that also. بالضبط صح. Okay. Yeah I did already بس لحظة بوزن.